James, congratulations. You've got a habit this season of scoring late goals in games.
Well, the lads put a massive effort in. Maybe it's the fitness, maybe it's the desire, but it's also a mentality to go and win games where it's a draw. First game of the season, we just pushed on. We went 4-4-2. Obviously, the momentum of the game, they're trying to see the game out at 1-0. And once you get the equaliser, you've got the right mentality to go and win the game. But eventually, our set plays counter took up pressure on them, because throughout the game I didn't think we showed enough quality in our open play or our set plays to really trouble them enough.
I know you sound disappointed about some of the play, particularly in the first hour or so of that game. What wasn't working? Why didn't you click in that first hour or so?
Well, I don't think we've been a very good footballing side all season. We don't know how to switch the play from throw-ins, we don't know how to combine. We've done a little bit of work during the week on Tuesday and Thursday on our shape and how to, if you like, pick up the ball and combine to score. And I've admitted that that's a mistake, because I never see them patterns. What we should be working on is set plays, defensive structure, defending crosses again. So, like I said, my mentality, if I have time during the week, then I'm trying to add something to us, and what we shouldn't do is... we need to focus on the things that really matter, which is our set plays and our defending.
Having said all of that, on the negative side, the positive is that your side responded really well to the setback of a goal, because I thought Alex Brown coming on really gave them some composure in the middle of the park. They got their goal, and you worried that they were going to sit in and soak up pressure.
Well, we changed the shape second half to a little bit more of a, if you like, a 4-3-3, and that sort of allowed John Marsden and Danny Lloyd not to be too troubled about the wingers, and it came at a cost in terms of Connor Hampson gets the ball quite high up the pitch and the fullbacks have got to react. But I'm still disappointed that we've not filled good zones on the cross, but like I said, it's up to Glenn Rule and Gary Stopford to put a little bit more pressure on the players in midfield, and I mean, Gary's got tremendous energy, and you know, Glenn needs more time on the pitch. He needs to get fitter to affect the game in terms of both his qualities and also defensively. But when I took Lewis off and we went 4-4-2, I felt that might, if you like, ease the trouble. And I just asked everybody to go man for man, get in the faces, stop the flow of them, pick up the ball, and just, like you said, put them under a little bit of pressure. And we did that. And when we did put them under pressure, we looked like scoring.
Fans helped, didn't they, today as well?
Well, it was great. It was reminiscent of Hensford. So yeah. I'm glad there wasn't a pitch invasion and smokes and flares and stuff like that. But no, I mean, the football hasn't been great. It hasn't been entertaining. But what people want in British football is excitement. They want massive effort. They want energy. I mean, I remember coming into the club, and that's what I was about. I was just fit and energetic and had a lot to learn, and wasn't always liked. And then once I learned how to play and learned the position and we started getting on a roll, then people are on your side, and I think people will always appreciate the effort and the energy and the purpose and the excitement of the drama of the finish we had. And it was nice because I joined in with a scarf, but no, it was great for the fans because they've come a long way and perhaps not been totally entertained and going away thinking they're buzzing like me and like the players, but are we good enough to be getting in the playoffs if we perform like that?
You may learn something on Tuesday night, I guess. And I was interested listening to your interview with Chris before the game today, where you said that 3 points today will take the pressure off a little bit on Tuesday, and anything you get from that game now will be a bonus.
Well, what we have to do is we, you know, like every team, you have to be respectful of the opposition, their threats, you know, the goals they've scored, the results they've had on the thing. I believe they've paid out a massive five-figure sum for another player. So, but from our point of view, we just need to be well organised, appreciate their threats, counteract that, and then make sure that we play to our strengths as well. And like I said, having 3 points here means that, like you said, there's a little bit more confidence, there's a little belief that we can go and finish games strongly. So from that perspective, it augurs well. But we just have to dust ourselves down, rejig the squad, see how we feel come Tuesday, and like I said, take the energy and the adrenaline that we've got in this game into that game on Tuesday.
And how's Jimmy Ball? He pulled up very sharply just in front of you during the game and then sort of limped through to half time. How was it?
Yeah, it was a strange one. Obviously, he's reacted to something. But I've had them sort of injuries before where I feel like the tendon rather than muscle seizes a bit. And you know, obviously if you have a muscle tear, you can't continue. But if the tendon or the top of the muscle strains a little bit, or you get a feel there, often you can continue. But I think the discretion was to take him off. And I felt that it was an ideal opportunity to try and give Glenn Rule and see if he can affect the game. So from our perspective, it was nice to be able to give people a few minutes without affecting the result.
In terms of, we've not had an opportunity to speak about the FA Cup as well, it's a terrific win over Hyde, and now you've got Salford in the next round. How did you feel about the draw when you came out of the hat against them?
I'd prefer to have Kersenstraw at home to a team that's a million miles away and below you, but yeah. Every game has its difficulties, and it's a tough one. It's a tough one for them, it's a tough one for us, but at the moment I'm not really thinking too hard about that game. Salford are a good side, they're very fit, good energy, and they know how to win games, so it won't be an easy game for us, but at the moment we're just sort of focusing on Tuesday night, because I'm keenly aware that the FA Cup's great on the day, and it's great when you continue Monday morning and you're in the next round, but ultimately when the fervour of the FA Cup dies down, we want to be at the right points level to be our season's very much alive.
And will the next two league games give you a check on where you are, and will you feel better maybe able to judge where your players are or how good your side is when you've played those two games in the league against Fylde and Salford?
Well, I think not just the Fylde game, but obviously the month of October is quite tough.
Yeah.
We've got not just Salford, we'll have Tamworth and Chorley, and we'll have teams that are up there and getting results and know how to win games. So there won't be any easy games in October. So what we have to do is make sure that any little soft underbelly, any little bit of weaknesses, that we're strong in that department, and that if you like, we work really hard to make ourselves competitive in those games and in a position to win those games. But like I said, we'll start with Fylde, because that'll be a real measure of our ability to get results against the top sides. I think we were lacking a little bit of confidence against Halifax at home, and we turned up the heat second half. But we used Adam Thomas in that game, and he had an ACL rupture. So, but like in the second half, we've turned up the heat against Halifax. So, a result like this will give us confidence. But a really good performance against Fylde will give us confidence going into not just the FA Cup, but a really tough month ahead.
And just finally, I know you are still tweaking your squad at this stage of the season, and Craig Carney, I think, has signed for Lancaster on a dual registration arrangement today. I think he was involved in their side today. Tell us what you're thinking is there, how you decided to reach that conclusion.
Well, last Saturday was FA Cup. We only had 19 fit players, 18, and Adam Metters is working his way back to fitness. We obviously got George West out on loan, and Ryan Ellison's on his way back now after having his operation. So we're going to have two or three players coming fitter and stronger over the next month that can supplement the squad. But I think Scott and Craig need minutes, and also depending on how things go in the FA Cup and budgetary constraints, we just have to look at whether they can affect the game. The non-contract players, we have to be respectful, give them plenty of notice. And I think Craig being out playing and getting games also protects him against any eventuality that he leaves the club. I think it was fantastic for him to get minutes today. Hopefully they've had a positive result. And we'll just take one game at a time. If we had Jimmy Ball's been injured today, so these things happen. But we've got a lad who's had a good 90 minutes under his belt. Craig would be probably part of the squad on Tuesday. So strange one for him playing for Lancaster on a Saturday, but we know he's got minutes under his belt now. So we have to be respectful and manage the whole group. Adam Metches, for example, has had a bit of a knee injury, and he's back up now to 70 minutes. So you know, we're looking forward to him to sort of step up and see if he can have an impact over the course of the season. George West went out on loan. We want to see if that can make a difference. So it's a squad game, and we have to be mindful of the player, all the players, and making sure they're all in good shape for when they're needed.
It's a great 3 points. Well done.
Thanks very much.